Some time ago, I showed you how I make my homemade aloe oil from fresh cut aloe vera leaves and coconut oil. I use it for soap making instead of coconut oil. But does it make a difference? Yes, it does. And I show you why. Hello and welcome back to another soap making video. If you're new here, I'm Sue. I make videos about how to make soap and the chemistry behind it. To find out if it makes any difference if using aloe oil or coconut oil, I made two single oil soaps for testing. For one, I used pure coconut oil and the other one I made with my homemade aloe oil. I made both soaps the same way with a 20% lye count and 34% lye concentration. The only additive I used was 3% citric acid. The aloe oil is made based on coconut oil, so the saponification value is the same for both oils, and I only had to prepare the lye solution once for both soaps. Coconut oil and aloe oil look different. Pure coconut oil is white and you get a very white soap out of it. The aloe oil looks more creamy white, yellowish or greenish. Because I made a double portion of the lye solution, I now have to split it into two equal parts. The lye solution and the oils are at room temperature for soaping. The left one is coconut oil, the right one is the aloe oil. With such a small amount of soap, there are always a lot of air bubbles when you use a stick blender. To release them, it helps to tap the container onto the table. I'm using single soap molds here. If you struggle with how much soap you need for filling these kinds of molds, you should watch my video about how to calculate soap mold volume. If you do some calculations before, you never have to worry about having too much or too little soap batter. You'll find a link in the upper right corner and the description below. Now let's do the aloe soap. I also used some rubbing alcohol to remove the air bubbles on the surface. The cured soaps look different and they also smell slightly different. I would say they also feel different when you use them. It's not that much, they are very similar because basically they are both coconut soap. Personally, I would say the aloe soap feels creamier and more nourishing and I like it more, but don't expect the difference to be that big. When you cook aloe in oil, all the good stuff inside the aloe will go into the oil and you get aloe-infused coconut oil. It is still coconut oil, but with the benefits of aloe vera, which is really cool. I like it very much. I hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you for watching, sharing and subscribing. Have a great day and see you next time.